Welcome to ABC Interactive English. This is Henry.
And this is Karen.
And today we will be looking at our jokes and fun. And it's called Not a Useful Schedule. And the vocabulary words are...
Railroad. Railroad. The railroad has trains that go down the East Coast.
Indicate. Indicate. This red light indicates that the machine has a problem.
Nearly. Nearly. We walked for nearly a mile before we found a shop.
Point. Point. There's no point in crying about your mistake.
That's right.
Do you like to take railroads?
Yeah, I do. Okay. I do in
Taiwan.
Have
you taken the railroads in Canada?
Not in Canada, but in Taiwan, yes.
Okay, and you enjoy taking the railroads?
Yeah.You can enjoy the view and the scenery.
Yes, especially down the East Coast.
Yes, it's beautiful there.
Yes, yes. I took my parents and my aunts and my uncle last year down to Taroko Gorge, and we took the Puyoma.
Ah, okay.
I'm sorry, I don't know how to say Puyoma in English. It's probably Puyoma. I would guess. I don't know. But that was a very, very nice train, and we had a great time on the railroad, chatting and eating and just, you know, being with the family and looking out of the window together.
That's right. I love the East Coast of Taiwan. It's beautiful. And when you go down to Taidong, Taidong is also very beautiful, too.
Yes.
You can take the railroad down to Taidong, Hualien, on the east side.
Mm-hmm. Do it.
Love it. That's right. And the question for today is, what did the businessman say to the engineer first?
What did the businessman say to the engineer first? Do it. If you haven't done it, do it. You owe it to yourself. You live in Taiwan.
Not a useful schedule. A businessman was waiting to catch a train. It was already 10 minutes late. When it finally arrived,The businessman went to talk to the engineer. I use this railroad to get to work, he said. So I always check the train schedule to find the next train. The schedule indicates that this train should arrive at 9 o'clock. However, it's late nearly every day. What's the point of having a schedule? Well, said the engineer,If we didn't have a schedule, how would you know that the trains are late?
Explanation 1.
Hi, I'm Jeff.
Hi, I'm Hanny.
Welcome to Jokes and Fun. Today we've got another joke for you guys. Joke number 2 for this month. Today's joke is called Not a Useful Schedule.
Okay, let's get started.The joke begins with this sentence. A businessman was waiting to catch a train.
That's right. This guy has been waiting around for a while and is starting to get angry. Why? Because the train was already 10 minutes late. And that's why, when it finally arrived, the businessman went to talk to the engineer.I imagine that he's going to say something along the lines of, Hey, I'm an important businessman and time is money. How dare you waste my precious time?
That's not what the businessman said exactly, but you're pretty close, Jeff. Anyways, the businessman did speak to the engineer. First, he said,
Stop.Stop right there, Hanny. You see, I almost forgot. Right now, it's time for the question of the day. What did the businessman say to the engineer first?
I use this railroad to get to work, he said. I use this railroad to get to work, he said. Oh, and before I forget, railroad is the first vocabulary word of the day.
Railroad. Railroad.It's a noun. Here, a railroad is a road made out of steel tracks. Tracks called rails, hence railroad. Anyways, trains use railroads in order to move people and things from place to place. By the way, the word railroad can also refer to a company that owns railroads and operates trains and stuff like that. For example, the railroad runs through the city.
铁路有穿越这个城市。好 ,railroad,railroad。Railroad, 这个单字它是名词，是用来指铁路或者是铁路公司。那其中这个 RAIL, rail, 它有铁轨的意思。例如 ,in the past, the railroad was used to transport logs. In the past, the railroad was used to transport logs. 过去这条铁路是用来运送木材的。那么句子里面这个 transport, 它表示运输、运送是当动词。好，再看个例句。He had worked for the railroad for 30 years. He had worked for the railroad for 30 years. 他以前在那家铁路公司工作做了30年了。好，那今天笑话标题是 Not a useful schedule. Schedule 在这边它是指时刻表。那为什么会说时刻表没有用呢？我们来看课文。有一名商人他在等火车，那火车晚了十分钟。当这班列车终于到站的时候，商人可能已经满肚子火了，他就跑去找这个工程人员理论。他告诉工程人员说，他都是搭这条铁路去上班的。Before we move on, everyone, let's make something clear. In this case, an engineer is kind of like a driver or pilot for a train and not a builder of planes and bridges, etc.
There you go.The engineer thinks the businessman is the person who is responsible for the train's lateness. Anyway, I use this railroad to get to my job, said the businessman. And the businessman is not done. He also said, I always check the train schedule to find the next train, and the schedule indicates that this train should arrive at 9 o'clock. Wow, what a windbag.
Very funny, Jeff. Also, let's not forget that the word indicate is the second vocabulary word of the day.
Indicate, indicate. It's a verb. Here, the word indicate has a meaning, kind of like the words say and show. Okay, this schedule contains information on trains.Namely, when trains arrive and depart from this train station. This schedule says this or has this information. Yes, the schedule shows these things or indicates these things. For example, he tapped on his watch impatiently, indicating to us that it was time to go.
他很不耐烦的用手指尖这样一直敲着手表，那这个动作就是说时间到了，该走了。好 ，indicate， indicate 这个单词是动词，意思是指出或是表明。例如 ，The study indicates that lack of sleep is bad for your health. The study indicates that lack of sleep is bad for your health. 研究指出睡眠不足对身体有害。再看个例句 ，She keeps biting her nails.And that indicates she is nervous. She keeps biting her nails, and that indicates she is nervous. 她一直在咬指甲，那这就表明了她很紧张。回到笑话里面，这位商人他固定会搭那一条铁路去上班。他说他都会查看火车时刻表来确认下一班车什么时候到，而且时刻表上面写的清清楚楚，这班车应该要九点到的啊。Everyone.I have news. The businessman is still not done talking.
I know. And we're going to read what he says next. After a break, that is. Yes, everyone, it is now time for a break, but stick around. We'll be back soon.
欢迎收看就爱讲英文，
我是悠悠，
是
你知道现在文明病很多，工作压力超大，过劳啊，你知道有时候公司主管在面试员工的时候都会问说，请问你平常的舒压跟消遣是什么呢？
对，你如何舒压呢？
这个很重要，
这个叫做你的情绪跟压力管理，就是 stress management
stress management
你怎么样管理自己的压力、Stress management 所以我们应该来看看要怎么去回答。
首先，舒压良方怎么说？
对，你怎么舒压 ？How do you handle stress?
How do you handle stress?
How do you handle stress? 你怎么去管控自己的压力呢？你怎么处理压力 ？How do you handle stress?
How do you handle stress?
或者是 What do you do to take care of yourself?
What do you do to take care of yourself?、
这个很重要嘛、self-care、这个是在美国很重要的一个职场概念。台湾现在也越来越多了，就是你要透过这种身心灵的方式让自己舒压、释放压力啊、这样的话比较不会疲劳，然后呢工作效率也可以提升。
我最喜欢的舒压方式就是下班之后去按摩、去按摩、还是去按摩，
对，真的很有效，对不对？
超有效。
按摩的话就是 get a massage，
get a massage。
所以你可以说 I usually get a massage after an exhausting day at work。
I usually get a massage after an exhausting day at work、
exhausting 就是精疲力竭，精疲力尽，然后就是你被操到爆这样，累死了，爆肝的这样。好，所以呢，我们可以把这个压力转为助力，这样也可以让你在面试上面表现得更好。
对自己按摩，哎，可是要怎么把压力转成助力啊？
那就看你怎么讲啊。OK， 看你的话术啊，没有，你就可以，你就可以讲，你可以说 ，I appreciate challenging tasks and I work better under pressure.
I appreciate challenging tasks and I work better under stress.
Under pressure.
Under
pressure.
就是
对，很厉害，很厉害的感觉，对不对？就是我喜欢，本人喜欢
挑战
性的工
作，
而且我在有
高度压力下，
适度压力下呢，表现的还比较好。
Under pressure，
对，
哇，很会耶，到底是不是真的
这样？对，举例你可以这样讲 ：reasonable pressure like that of a deadline helps me to focus on my work。合理的，对，合理的压力哈，比如说这个有时间的限制哈，截稿的时间呐、大米在催我，对不对？哦，超快的，帮助我可以专注在工作上面。
肾上腺素，
对对对
，deadline 很重要。
对对对，
大家都很怕。
对，就是截稿日、
死期到了，
时间要交的，就要交稿的时间，工作要完成的那个时间点就是 deadline。
哎、可是抗高压的
抗压性，
抗压性高。
OK， 就是你很会处理自己的压力。OK，、你可以说 handle my stress well。
Handle my stress well.
所以藉由做什么事情 ？I handle my stress well by doing something.、所以比如说呢 ，I handle my stress well by maintaining efficient time management.
Time 什么
？Management.
Management.
Management 就是时间管理。对，所以我透过就是良好的时间管理呢，可以让我舒压。这句话有没有很厉害？
哇，很会呢。
Hey, I handle my stress well by maintaining efficient.Time management，
这样主管会走心哦。
马上录取，
马上爱上。
对，
好了，我们来看今天的
life action。
How do you normally handle stress？
Stress 啊
，Yeah。
I usually get a massage after an exhausting day at work。Yes。And I also handle stress by managing my time efficiently.
Really?
Yes. Reasonable pressure, like that of a deadline, helps me to focus on my work.
Oh, that makes sense.
Explanation 2.
Welcome back. Before the break, a businessman confronted the engineer of a late train.He wanted to know why the 9 o'clock train was not on schedule. He wanted to know why this train had arrived late. And he's not done either.
Right. Apparently, the 9 o'clock train is almost always late.
It's late nearly every day, said the businessman. As such, what's the point of having a schedule?
Jeff, I don't know about you, but I feel the punchline of this joke coming on. That being said, before we can read on, we need to define both the third and fourth vocabulary words of the day.
Nearly. Nearly. It's an adverb. The adverb nearly means close to or almost. Here, if the 9 o'clock train is late nearly every day, it's late almost every day. For example, the rich man spent nearly $1 million on his cat.
很多人都把宠物当作自己的小孩养，很愿意把钱花在毛小孩身上。不过这位有钱人也太夸张了，他花了将近$1,000,000哎。好 ，nearly， 这个单字它是副词，表示几乎或是差不多。例如 ，We've known each other for nearly 10 years. We've known each other for nearly 10 years. 我们认识差不多快十年了。好，再看个例句。Nearly all of the students passed the exam. Nearly all of the students passed the exam. 几乎所有的学生都通过考试了。好，那其实 nearly 也可以表达出差一点就怎么样的语义，像是 The tennis player nearly lost the game. The tennis player nearly lost the game. 那位网球选手他差一点就输掉比赛，他几乎要输掉比赛了。好，那接着我们来学今天最后一个单字是 point。And point is the final vocabulary word of the day.
Point. It's a noun. Here the word point refers to the reason for something or the purpose of something. Here the businessman is not wrong. If the trains run late pretty much every day, why have a schedule at all? If this schedule cannot tell you when the trains arrive and depart, what's the pointof it. Why have it at all? For example, there's no point in arguing anymore. You win.
好啦好啦，算你赢了，再争论下去也没有什么意义。Point. 这个单字当名词，它有分数或是点的意思，像4.3要念作 4.3. 不过 point 在课文里面它表示目的或是意义。例如What's the point of having these action figures if you're not going to play with them? What's the point of having these action figures if you're not going to play with them? 如果你没有要玩的话，有这些公仔有什么意义呢？好，另外我们可以用 there is no point in 加上动词 ing 来表达做某事没有意义。例如 ，There's no point in crying over spilled milk. There's no point in crying over spilled milk.打翻牛奶哭是没有意义的。那其实这句话就相当于中文的覆水难收 ，cry over spilled milk， 为了打翻的牛奶哭泣。那引申的意思就是说，为了已经发生没办法挽回的事情而沮丧。好，回到课文里面，商人对铁路工程人员说：“哎，这个时刻表上面明明写的这班车9点会到，可是几乎每天都误点，那还要时刻表干嘛 ？”Okay, everyone, it is now time to hear from the engineer. I get the feeling that.He will be delivering this joke's punchline. So, Mr. Engineer, what's the point of having a schedule if the trains always run late?
Well, said the engineer, if we didn't have a schedule, how would you know that the trains are late? Huh? Did you get it? Huh? Funny, right? Yeah.
Indeed.The engineer, though possibly slightly dim, has shut the businessman down. Now, did he mean to do so? Well, that's a discussion for a different time and place.
Right. Why? Because today's joke is done. Anyway, it is now time for a break, but don't go away. We'll be back with more fun next time. Shoshi sha ma shang kui lai. Oh.
Not a useful schedule. A businessman was waiting to catch a train. It was already 10 minutes late. When it finally arrived, the businessman went to talk to the engineer. I use this railroad to get to work, he said. So I always check the train schedule to find the next train. The schedule indicates that this train should arrive at 9 o'clock.However, it's late nearly every day. What's the point of having a schedule? Well, said the engineer, if we didn't have a schedule, how would you know that the trains are late?
看全民说英语，我是 Daphne。今天我们总共要介绍三则文法，第一则是赶上火车的搭配词 catch a train， 第二则是晚了十分钟的形容词片语 10 minutes late， 第三则是去上班的动词片语 get to work。 让我们从赶上火车的搭配词开始吧。 catch a train 意思是赶上火车，Catch 在这里是及物动词，赶上，及时赶到。三态是 catch, coat, coat， 后方可以接 train 火车， bus 公车， flight 飞机当受词。例如 This morning Duncan called the train to Paris， 今天早上邓肯赶上开往巴黎的火车。接着来看下一则文法， 10 minutes late 意思是晚了十分钟，Late 是形容词，晚了，迟了的意思，前方可以用时间名词表示晚了多久。例如 The procrastinator was 2 hours late， 这个拖拉大王迟到2小时。接着来看下一则文法， Get to work 意思是去上班， Get to 是动词片语抵达，把点点点送到，其后接地方名词 work， 在这里是指上班地点。例如 Kevin gets to work at 9 o'clock every morning， 凯文每天早上9点上班。以上就是今天的三则文法，全民说英语，我们下次见咯。
A sentence a day.
Hello, welcome to A Sentence a Day with me, Henry. Now, 有时候借东西的时候，我们可能先跟人家讲说我只要借多久多久，可是到后来我需要的时间更长，那你要去跟人家说一声哦，不能忘记了，你不能说哦，我刚才本来说马上就还你了，可是我现在需要用的时间比较久一点，我就不用跟你讲了，我继续使用下去，等到你来跟我要的时候可能就有点尴尬了。所以呢，如果有时间借的时间要延长的话，记得提醒别人一下。 And the sentence for today is Can I use your hammer for just a little longer? 铁锤可以再借我久一点吗？Yes, you know, sometimes you just need to borrow something, and sometimes you just need it a little longer before you return it. You need more time with it. You need to do more work on it. You need to use it more. There are plenty of reasons, right? But remember to tell the other person. Tell the person that you borrow the thing from, okay? And say, thank you. I just need this a little longer. Okay, and the sentence for today is, Can I use your hammer for just a little longer?Sure you can, since you asked so nicely, you could use it for just a little longer. See you next time. Bye-bye.
Hello, 大家好，我是 Hanny， 又到我们一分钟的单元喽。那我们今天要一分钟的时间来复习在 Jokes and Fun 学到的四个单字。同学们，您都准备好没？一分钟计时开始。第一单词是铁路，铁路怎么说呢？叫做 railroad。 rail 是铁轨，铁轨的路就是铁路嘛， railroad。 The railroad was built over 100 years ago， 那条铁路是在100多年前建造的。第二单词它是指指出或者是表明，这个字比较难一点，叫做 indicate。 indicate The green light indicates that the battery is fully charged亮绿灯就表示这个电池已经完全充好电了。再看第三个单字是几乎，不是姐夫，是几乎差不多那个意思，这字叫做 nearly。 We nearly missed the train， 我们差一点就错过那班火车了。第四个单字它可以指点啊或是分数，可是在课文里面要指目的或是意义，叫这字就叫做 point。What's the point of having a camera if you always take photos with your phone？ 如果你都是用手机在拍照，那拥有一台相机又有什么意义呢？好，太好了，我们在一分钟之内完成任务，顺利复习完四个单字了，同学表现很棒哦。那回去也要多多复习。今天的 ABC Interactive English 到此为止，下次见咯，拜拜。